I reflect that I was in Africa, in Mozambique border in 1996-97, and had terrible difficulty adjusting to what was the way everyone viewed life, and particularly for women. And it's exactly as you both said about maternal morbidity and HIV. Women would come to the hospital, they'd give birth, and they'd die with TB overnight. And or they'd come, they'd have pneumocystis, pneumonia from HIV, and everyone would just say, oh, don't worry about it. And I'd say, she's 17 and she's got three children already, and how can you possibly just let her die? Oh, don't worry about it. Go home, you know. If you're from Australia, you wouldn't understand. And things have improved somewhat. I think there is some recognition of the value of a woman's life more than there was then, but it's a struggle. And it's a struggle because of the poverty and because of all those, of many of the issues that you mentioned about empowerment of women and what's thought to be their role and their place in that society. I must say for myself, I walked away from Africa and thought, I can't go back now until I've got something I can offer and something better to give. And as you say though, now there is very good treatment for the prevention of transmission of HIV to children. And that surely is, you know, one of the first places that every woman, every child should have a right to that.